Good morning, madam. Hello, good morning, madam.
Ha, sir, bola, good morning. Good morning.
Hello, good morning, madam.
हाँ सर बोला ऐकू येत आहे
ठीक आहे मॅडम ऑनरेबल चीफ साहेब आणि सगळेजण लॉर्डशिप आलेले आहेत प्लीज आपण कार्यक्रम सुरू करता थँक्यू
सर करूयात का सुरू
यस प्लीज
Honorable the Chief Justice of Bombay High Court, Shri Dipankar Datta sir, other honorable judges of Bombay High Court, legal luminaries, galaxy of intellectuals, and my dear friends, I, Advocate Anagha Pedgaonkar, welcome you all to the inaugural session of virtual lecture series organized by High Court Bar Association, Aurangabad. With this unprecedented lockdown, everything has come to an abrupt halt, to which legal field is not an exception. With an aim of utilizing this unprecedented lockdown period by harnessing the striding technology, HCBA Aurangabad aims to bring some quality material at your doorstep by organizing virtual lecture series. And today, for our inaugural session, we are delighted to have Honorable Shri Justice Dipankar Datta sir, the Chief Justice of Bombay High Court, as a chief guest. Honorable Justice S.S. Shinde sir, as a guest of honor. Honorable Justice P.B. Varaye sir, as a guest of honor. And Honorable Shri Justice S.V. Gangapurwala sir. Not taking more time, I request Advocate Surekha Mahajan ma'am, President HCBA Aurangabad, to provide preface of today's session. Over to you, ma'am. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Anagha. Honorable Shri Justice Dipankar Datta, the Chief Justice, Bombay High Court, Honorable Shri Justice S.S. Shinde, and Honorable Shri Justice Prasanna Barai, Judge, Bombay High Court, Honorable Shri Justice S.V. Gangapurwala, the Administrative Judge, Bombay High Court, Bench at Aurangabad, Honorable Companion Judges of this Honorable High Court, former judges of this court, members of Bar Council of Maharashtra and Goa, senior counsels, senior advocates, my colleagues and my friends, a very, very good morning. And I convey my best wishes on this Marathwada Mukti Sangram Din, which is also known as a Marathwada Liberation Day. It marks the anniversary of Marathwada's integration with India on 17th of September 1948. That is 13 months after the independence. Therefore, it has a special significance for the people of this region. I salute the freedom fighters who were on front and sacrificed their lives. We are indeed very happy to start with the academic pursuit by this erudite session of inauguration of lecture series. Friends, we have been departed due to the pandemic that created devastation. In spite of this, we all are connected because of the common platform which we all share, and that is this Honorable High Court. Now, to keep growing ourselves and updated in a legal field in this unexpected pandemic period, it's impossible for not cashing on the opportunity of auspicious presence of Honorable the Chief Justice. Our Bar Association has decided to inaugurate a lecture series on a virtual platform. I think this is the best time to mold, to make indulge and industrious the junior members of the bar in turn channelizing their potential, their view, innovative ideas through these lecture series, wherein they will be guided on developing the art and science of advocacy, drafting, pleading, and effective communication skills, along with the traditional subjects like IPC, CRPC, Constitution, we can add cyber law, etc. It is always said that our Bar Association is an amalgamation of several virtues, such as we have artists, sportsmen, orators, etc. Considering the above resources, the association has planned to utilize the state talent of an individual as a source of energy to inculcate among the junior members to develop their overall personality so as to join the mainstream. Therefore, on this occasion, the senior counsel, senior advocates are requested to develop and deliver the opulence of their knowledge in the lectures as per their convenience. I request all the senior as well as junior members to contribute and respond to this lecture series on a virtual platform. This endeavor was also done last year, and Honorable Justice B.R. Gawai, Justice Supreme Court of India, had delivered a lecture on a constitution. So this time also, we are having this endeavor to have the highest, we have that the highest number of juniors should take a benefit of it. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. We are profusely elated to have a man of distinct vision and a fountainhead of illuminating ideas as an administrative judge of Aurangabad bench of Bombay High Court, Honorable Justice S.V. Gangapurwala sir. I request Honorable Justice Gangapurwala sir to address the attendees. Please do the honor, sir. Over to you.
Thank you. My Lord, the Honorable the Chief Justice of the Bombay High Court, Sri Dipankar Datta, the members of the Administrative Committee, Brother Justice Sambhaji Shinde and Brother Justice Prasanna Varale, my sister and brother judges, the President, the Secretary of the Bar Association, and my fellow members of the Bar. At the outset, I congratulate the Managing Committee for commencing the lecture series. It is said that the greatest wealth is wisdom and knowledge. Lecture series would be media to share the knowledge. The senior members of the Bar would certainly impart and share their knowledge with the young members of the Bar. It is said that an advocate is a badge of honor and patent of trustworthiness, not merely as an agent of the client, but also as an officer of the court. Thus, I request the senior members of the Bar to guide the young members of the Bar and tell them about the etiquettes, the court mannerisms, their duty towards the client, their duty towards the opponent, and their duty towards the court. It is also said that adversities create opportunities. Now, with less number of courts functioning, the young members of the Bar would have some time at their disposal. I would request the young members of the Bar to have a group discussion every day or at least 3-4 days in a week. Because of group discussion, the ideas would be clear, the niceties of the provisions of law would be more clear. It is only through discussions, new ideas would come up, the new ways of interpreting the provisions would come up. So I appeal to the young members of the Bar to have group discussions, to form a group and have discussions every day. That would help them a lot. I think today, we are gathered here to hear our Honorable Chief Justice, who is the reservoir of knowledge. So I would not like to be a barrier between you all and the Honorable the Chief Justice. I wish all the best for the lecture series in the offing. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. We are delighted to have an idol of knowledge, experience, and inspiration to all of us as guest of honor of today's function, Honorable Justice P.V. Varare, sir. I request His Lordship to address the gathering. Over to you, sir. Please do the honors.
A very good morning to all. Honorable the Chief Justice, Sri Dipankar Dattaji, my esteemed colleague, Justice Shinde, Justice Gangapurwala, my sister and brother judges who have joined us either physically or virtually, I express my best wishes to all and congratulate the High Court Bar Association of Aurangabad for arranging this lecture series. I also welcome Honorable the Chief Justice Sri Dipankar Dattaji, who is visiting to Aurangabad, and I feel privileged and I thank Honorable Sri Dipankar Dattaji for accepting our invitation. My Lord, Marathwada region of our state is known for its rich cultural heritage. It is also known for its spiritual legacy as land of saints, land of world heritage, Ajanta and Ellora, land of adab and tehzeeb, And this is the land where the architect of Indian Constitution, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, started his mission of uplifting hundreds of young youth of the depressed and oppressed class by establishing the education institute, namely Milind Mahavidyalaya or Milind College. My Lord, allow me to share with sense of little pride that our former judges, Honorable Justice A.V. Samant, Justice N.P. Chepalgaonkar, our guru, senior advocate, Vijay Kumar Ji Gangapurwala, father of my esteemed colleague, Sanjay Gangapurwala, Sri Mitchell Rao Ghuge, the then Vice Chancellor and father of Brother Justice Ravindra Ghuge, are the first batch, are the members of the first batch of graduates from Milind Mahavidyalaya, Milind College. My Lord, this is the land which is also known for Wali Dakhni, who can be said as a pioneer of Urdu language in general and Urdu Shairi in particular. And I must mention, my Lord, our own Bashar Nawaz, who was known for his poetry, not only the continent, but beyond the continent and globally known for his best poems. And one of the poems turned into a classic song of silver screen from the movie Bazaar. And Bashar Nawaz was one of this a famous shair produced by this town city. Historians and scholars state that city of Aurangabad was earlier known as Pratishthan and was famous for even trade and commerce to other countries, a rich town. City of Aurangabad was developed by Malik Ambar, who was a minister and chief of army of Murtaza Nizam Shah II, who came to Aurangabad from Ahmednagar in year 1610. And in those days, this town was known as Khadki. Malik Ambar Nagar, and in year 1653, Emperor Shah Jahan appointed his son Aurangzeb as Subedar of South, and Aurangzeb renamed this city as Aurangabad on his name. It will be interesting to note Aurangabad is also referred as Gojishta Buniyad by some of the historians. That was City of Joy. In year 1762, Nizam Ali Khan II shifted his capital from Aurangabad to Hyderabad. Then this region was ruled by Nizam and then by a historic struggle, the Marathwada region was liberated, and then on this auspicious day, 17 September 1948, it became part of the independent India. My Lord, we all are the members of justice delivery system. We are aware of the importance of basic principles, liberty, equality, fraternity. My Lord, allow me to mention and share, and allow me to take this opportunity to recall the words of great Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore, who had penned the concept of liberty, freedom, beautifully. And in those famous words of Rabindranath says, Chitto jetha bhayashunyam, uccha jetha shir, jnana jetha mukto, jetha grahar prachir. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the word has not been broken up, into fragments by narrow domestic walls here in India, O my father, arouse the people to create heaven on earth. In this poem, Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore, besides political freedom, also appeals to God for social, educational, and economical freedom of India. My Lord, it may not be out of place to state here that this beautiful poem of Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore is also translated by one of our famous Marathi poet, Vasant Bapat, with these words. And once again, wishing all the very best to this lecture series and congratulating the High Court Bar Association. And once again, thanking my Lord, I end my speech and take your leave. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. We are also privileged to have a dynamo, a power source, Honorable Justice S.S. Shinde, sir, as a guest of honor. I request Honorable Justice S.S. Shinde, sir, to address the attendees. Please do the honor, sir. Over to you.
Honorable the Chief Justice, my esteemed colleagues, members of the Bar Council of Maharashtra and Goa, President of the Bar Association, Secretary, other office bearers, senior advocates, and members of the Bar. Hyderabad Mukti Sangramacha, aplya sagalyanla hardik shubhechha. Apan he lecture series suru kelela ahe, atyant upyukta sagalyanla tharnar ahe, ani mukhyatah junior members barche je ahet tyanchyasathi he upyukta tharnar ahe. When we enter in the High Court premises, we read the preamble. Now the role of the judiciary, lawyers, is not only restricted to their profession, but when we read the preamble reads, we the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into sovereign, secular, democratic, republic, and social. Now, the word secular and social has been added by the 42nd Amendment in the Constitution of India. And therefore, what is our duty towards the society apart from the profession which you are doing? Because Article 39A has been introduced with definite intent and purpose, and it is our collective duty, or it should be our collective endeavor to extend the legal aid to the oppressed classes of the society, weaker section of the society, children, women, and all other citizens of the country who are deprived from the having the financial source and consequently not having the sufficient money to approach the court. The important role of the judiciary, lawyers, and legal fraternity is to give the justice and legal aid to those persons who are really need it. That is first. Second, as you know that in Keshwanand Bharati, it has been held that the separation of powers, separation of powers is basic structure of the Constitution of India. There are three wings of the state. Number one, legislature, executive, and judiciary. Now, what is important is independence of the judiciary. As we notice every day in the neighboring countries, what is happening with the judiciary? But here we are performing independently. In our country, constitution is supreme, and therefore it should be our duty to follow the provisions of the constitution. Every source of the power is traceable in the constitution. In the constitution, part 3 of the constitution is very important, wherein, as all of you know, that equality before law and equal protection of law. There shall not be discrimination on the basis of race, caste, religion, etc., wherein our role comes. There is also provision for weaker section, that is, special provision is made for children and women. Now, the legislatures with an specific intent and purpose have brought the Juvenile Justice Act. Now it's amended. Earlier there were 70 sections, now there are 110 sections. And for deprived children, we have to do the justice. Apart from it, the liberty of the individual is very important. Article 21 says that no person shall be deprived from his liberty, life and liberty, except in accordance with due procedure of law. That is not restricted only to the citizens. Even the foreigners who come in the in our country, that also they also should get the benefits which are available in Part 3 of the Constitution of India. It is not that the Part 3 is totally restricted to the citizens of this country. So, independent of the judiciary, again at the cost of reputation, I will repeat, because we have to, we are passing through the very tough time, and therefore it is the collective responsibility of the bench and bar to maintain the independence of the judiciary. Apart from it, many rights are given by the Constitution to the minorities, religious minorities, linguistic minorities, and that also we have to ensure that they get the benefit or the fruits of the fundamental rights which are enshrined in the Constitution of India to them. Apart from it, there are you have to, when you are functioning, you have to weigh the balance between the Part 3 and Part 4 of the Constitution of India, fundamental rights and directive principles in Part 4, so as to render the justice or give justice to the society. I think all of you are eagerly waiting to hear the Honorable the Chief Justice, and therefore I conclude my few words. Once again, I extend the wishes to all of you, and this very good step forward to start this lecture series through video conferencing, virtual. All the best. Have a nice day.
Thank you so much, sir. Moving forward, a renowned motivator and felicitator, he stands tall amidst the galore of flagships of justice. His aura has lent a unique charm to this session. We are privileged to have Honorable the Chief Justice Dipankar Datta sir with us today. I prerogate his lordship to address the attendees. Please do the honor, sir. Over to you, sir.
My dear colleagues on the bench of the Bombay High Court, esteemed members of the bar, the invitees who have joined this webinar, and last but not the least, the organizers of this function, a very good morning to all of you. I take this opportunity of extending to you my warm greetings and best wishes on the occasion of Marathwada Mukti Din, or the Liberation Day. Although India achieved its independence on 15th August 1947, after years of colonial rule, the people of Marathwada achieved freedom in the truest sense on this day in 1948. While celebrating this special day, we ought to remind ourselves the sacrifices made by the patriots who, leaving aside everything, dedicated themselves to bring about a liberated society. My salutations to them. I'm sure the audience is well and truly aware of the significance of this day in the annals of the freedom struggle leading up to the framing of the Indian Constitution, the organic document and the supreme law which regulates our lives day in and day out. It is the primacy of the rule of law which is the bedrock of our constitution, with rights and duties complementing each other. While we all feel liberated to enjoy the rights that the Constitution confers on us, oftentimes we tend to forget the duties that are enshrined in Part 4A of the Constitution. However, it is no part of my duty today to lecture to you on why it is important to adhere to the fundamental duties. That can be a subject matter of the lecture series that the organizers henceforth seek to initiate, and for which this inaugural session has been arranged. I am proud to have been awarded the honor to inaugurate the lecture series, and hope and trust that the lecture series, as and when in full swing, would attract more and more viewers and contribute in fair measure to their knowledge, erudition, and enlightenment. I echo the sentiments expressed by brothers Justices Gangapurwala, Varale, and Shinde, that the senior members of the bar should come forward. The senior members of the bar form the karta of the Bar Association. It is for them to nurture the raw talent that would be entering the legal profession. I congratulate the organizers for such noble initiative. The Liberation Day celebration, notwithstanding what is painful and agonizing in today's world, is the inability to liberate ourselves from the deadly virus, which has impacted our lives like nothing before. I, as the Chief Justice, am fully conscious of the hardship, difficulty, and inconvenience through which a large section of the audience is passing through. I, together with my colleagues, have been constantly at work, both on the administrative as well as the judicial side, to ensure access to justice to all for whom we as judges exist. Having been made to encounter an unknown enemy, we are rather compelled to tread the path of caution and circumspection, but at the same time are alive and firm to honor our commitment to the Constitution. The President and the Secretary of the Advocates Association has requested me to give a message with regard to the present day conditions and whether in the near future we would be opening up more courts and revert to the physical hearing mode. May I share on this platform that I have held meetings with the President and the Secretary yesterday more than once, and the concerns expressed by them have been considered by me. Every possible endeavor shall be made to address the concerns to the extent possible in the given circumstances, to ensure that the glitches being faced by you in course of hearing through the virtual platform are minimized, if not eradicated. I assure you that as and when the prevailing circumstances arising out of the pandemic change for the better, we shall revert to physical hearings in courts, but obviously upon maintaining the prescribed protocol for prevention of the spread. I propose to visit Aurangabad every quarter and join my colleagues here in dispensing justice to all. Looking forward to your wholehearted cooperation and assistance in this regard. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, sir. Your motivation will be cherished in the years to come. Thank you so much, sir. Now, I would like to request Advocate Shahaji Ghatol Patil, Secretary HCBA Aurangabad, to extend deep sense of gratitude. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Anuga. Our most valued invited chief guest of today's virtual inauguration function, Honorable Sri Justice Dipankar Datta, the Chief Justice of Bombay High Court, Honorable Sri Justice S.S. Shinde, Judge Bombay High Court, Honorable Sri Justice Prasanna Varale, Judge Bombay High Court, Honorable Sri Justice S.V. Gangapurwala, the senior most judge of the Aurangabad bench of the Bombay High Court, the President of Bar Association Advocate Surekha Mahajan, virtually present all honorable sitting judges of High Court of Bombay bench at Aurangabad, respected designated senior advocate, members of the Bar Council, senior and my senior and junior colleagues of the bar, invited guests and virtually present dignitaries and media persons. A very good morning to all. I take this privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this auspicious occasion on behalf of the Bar Association of Aurangabad Bench. I extend a very hearty vote of thanks to our admirable chief guest of today's function, Honorable Shri Justice Dipankar Datta, who has traveled all the way from Mumbai to Aurangabad and visited Aurangabad even in this pandemic situation. My lords further assured to take sitting at Aurangabad bench at every quarter of the year. I especially thanks to my lords for accepting our invitation and inaugurating this virtual lecture series and had an interaction with members of the Bar Association in spite of his busy schedule. My lords blessed to Aurangabad bench of Bombay High Court and positively considered all the difficulties faced by the members of the Bar Association and solved those difficulties positively immediately without any hesitation. And we hope in future also, my lords will help and support us with wholeheartedly. Also thankful to Honorable Shri Justice S.S. Shinde, Judge Bombay High Court, Honorable Shri Justice Prasanna Varale, Judge Bombay High Court, Honorable Shri Justice S.V. Gangapurwala, Senior Most Judge of the High Court of Bombay Bench at Aurangabad, who has given us their precious time and enlightened us and grace this virtual occasion with their valuable presence. I also thankful to Honorable Sitting Judges of the High Court of Bombay Bench at Aurangabad, who have given us their precious time and grace this occasion with their valuable presence. I also thanks to Honorable Judges who are came from outside as well as present virtually on this virtual event. I also thankful to all respected dignitaries, senior advocates of Honorable High Court of Bombay Bench at Aurangabad, members of Bar Council who have given their precious time and graced this occasion virtually with their valuable presence. I also thankful to the Honorable Registrar Administration, Sri Rajendikar, Registrar Judicial Sri Bhosle, and other officials of the High Court of being present virtually and help us for effectively managing this function. I also thankful to the office bearer of the Bar Association for their endeavors and for efficiently managing and organizing this event. Last but not least, I would like to extend my heartly thanks to all my dear junior and senior colleagues virtually present here. With this note, I declare that today's virtual inaugural function is over. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. I declare that the inaugural session is being concluded. Thank you everyone for evincing interest in today's session. Hope you have a wonderful day ahead. Thank you so much.